so it's Monday morning. The sun's finally getting out and breaking through the clouds after about a day and a half now of off and on rain and lightning and what have you. So since I got here, I've been wanting to get up and check out some of these hills, do a little exploring. So I'm gonna go see what I can get to today. For what I understand, reading online, this one peak, the one that's formerly called Saddle Mountain, apparently, that one's a technical climb, so as it looks like anyways. But there's not some mysterious easy route from what I've been able to read. One of the other more eastern sections you can get to, just on foot without ropes or anything. So we'll go see, climb up a little ways and explore, see what it looks like. And so let's go see what we can find up here. Base of the mountain now. I just now walked onto what appears to be an established hiking path, so we'll try following that for a bit and see how it goes. I've just really been enjoying this walk this morning so far. It is so green for the desert, and poppies in bloom all over the place. A lot of birds flying around this morning, much more than I'm used to seeing in the desert, so that's been really cool. So anyway, here we go. We'll see what I can find up here. Trail crosses over a gravelly wash here on its way into the mountains. It appears that the trail kind of runs in with this dry wash coming down the side of the mountain. Some pretty interesting rocks in here. Now this I just had to share. Found this sitting on a rock right in the middle of this wash. There's even actually a little bit of water up in some crevices of this rock after the rain. And a couple of fairly deep puddles. I'm starting to see some ocotillo now as I get further up away from the valley. There's actually a half dozen of them anyways right around here. I had not seen any here yet, so that's kind of interesting to find them up here. Yeah, time for a quick breather. Part way up this first section of the climb. Really nice view though. Turned out to be a gorgeous day as well, which is really nice. My van is down there. You can't really see it, I don't think, in the video, but I'll try and point to it for you. right about there. It's just about three quarters of it's visible sticking out from behind that hill. Interstate 10 is actually off in the distance there. I don't know if you'll be able to see it on the video or not, but it's before that next range of mountains over there. And that's looking to the north right now. The good news is you can barely see it from where we're camped in the valley. You can see it better up here. And the noise doesn't really come across. I don't know if I've heard it at all, actually, which is good. So it's a couple miles away. There are a couple of small caves along this outcropping. This other outcropping, which is just right near the last one, also has some caves in it. It looks like this little hole has been used apparently as a bird's nest. Just to give you an idea of the size of this cave, I can stand up completely in it. And have a few inches above my head still. So it's not wide enough or big enough to lay down in. Well, you can put your feet over there and lay down, I guess, but it's a good size, a small cave, assuming you trust it not to come down on you in the weather or something. I've had a few pieces of this stuff flake off just while I'm here. So I'm not sure what all the materials are here. I know the two end peaks, Saddle Mountain and whatever's on the other end, are volcanic peaks. And then apparently this whole ridge in the middle, between them, is just a plate shifting, heaving it up, from what I've been reading the last couple days since I've been here. This material and a lot of what I've been scrambling across coming up here is sort of like a bad concrete mixture. There's aggregate or stone in it with a mortar type material. I don't know what it is, but it binds all this loose stuff together, but it's really crumbly. All you have to do is just brush it and it crumbles and comes apart, which makes it really interesting coming up on a steep climb, because you think you're on something that looks like concrete and it's pretty hard packed, but it can crumble with no warning. I just came across yet another cave in the same outcropping. This one's the biggest yet. Onward and upward. Now here's another just huge cave. It's caused by, you can see where it's caused by the water undercutting. But I was actually standing on top of this when I shot the last clip. And then I came around and found this. Basically what I've been standing on was, looks like it's probably six to 10 feet thick at points, but the whole underside is all gone. Wow, here is yet another undercut section forming some small caves. I knew from looking down below, it looked like there were maybe a couple small caves up here, but I had no idea how many I was gonna find. Okay, so I got myself boxed in here, checking out these caves, and now there's no realistic way forward without having to backtrack. So, time to backtrack a little ways and find a way around. Obviously, the bighorn sheep get up here. I don't know which way they're coming in. I actually was following a sort of path for a little bit that I thought maybe was a hiking trail that I lost down there somewhere in that wash. Thought at one point I was following a hiking trail around the corner here by these caves. I had lost the trail somewhere back there in the wash down a ways, so I've been bushwhacking since then. Judging by the scat and the location here, and I'm guessing this is actually a bighorn sheep trail. Apparently they are known to be in this collection of mountains here. So that'd be really cool if I got to see bighorns, but they've left their calling card behind, and apparently that was a bighorn sheep trail that I was following, which makes sense because it was pretty scary a few points. All right, so I'm gonna go find my way around, hopefully find a way around this hill. Well, I've picked up an uninvited guest that wants to tag along for the hike, I guess. I have found another cluster of flowers that I don't know how to identify, so maybe some of my viewers will be so kind as to point these out to me again. I'll come out here and hike around and find them, and y'all can tell me what the heck they are that I'm looking at. Well, the good news is the phone still works, since I'm recording that with this. The bad news is it has a nice dent in the back of the case now. Well, you can kind of see where I was walking, I guess. I got stuck again. I made another attempt to get around and got stuck by that cave where the bighorn sheep had been, and tried another place and got stuck yet again. And I was trying to work my way around that. And yeah, I was talking earlier, I guess, about how loose some of this ground is, and it just, ground was gone. Landed on my backside. This little Palo Verde bush here helped catch my fall with all the spikes in it, I guess. The good news is I'm only on a steep slope here. I got, 8 or 10 feet till it drops off steep in a little cliff. I was thinking exactly this earlier a few times up here, you know, and it's like, boy, if I slip, it's like, you know, you're going right off. I mean, fortunately, none of them are huge cliffs like this one back behind me, you know, but you're going off, you know, 6, 8, 10 foot cliffs oftentimes. It's going to hurt. So no harm done other than dinging up the iPhone case, but boy, maybe I shouldn't keep it in my back pocket. I don't have a shirt with a front pocket on, and oh well. So a bit of a headache from the spinal impact landing on rock like that from a standing position, but you know, it's all right. It's all good. We'll keep on. Well, I did it again. This time I at least had the phone in my front pocket. Probably a good thing. Landed on my right side and right hip this time. I'm almost back to some better ground. It's just really loose up here, and it doesn't take much to, you know, you're on a steep slope and the ground and the surface is loose. If it slides on you, man, there's no, you know, I should have hiking poles. That would maybe give me a little more wiggle room. But yeah, that's it for now anyway. All right, I made it to what's gonna be the top for me today. That, behind that rock outcropping down there on the valley floor where the van is. That is the, let me show you a little better, this hideous scree slope I came up. Probably doesn't really show how steep it is, but it's obscenely steep. Like climbing, worse than a staircase, honestly. Steeper than a staircase. And loose, but I only fell 3 times. Only made myself bleed once. Oh, this is more of the mountains to the east. More to the south. And to the west we have Saddle Mountain. And you can kind of see a little bit how big it is anyways, I guess. Anyhow, I need to find a better way down so I don't end up getting seriously hurt, because that was, ever since I lost the trail, that was just way too rough. It wasn't bad at first because I was following a real hard pack wash with solid stones, solid big rocks and stuff up, and that was fine. It was once I had that basically petered out and I was across basically scree, and you know, after 3 falls, even being careful just because the ground just disappears on you, you know, it's time to consider an alternate route down, I think. I see some nice fields in the distance, irrigated farm fields, and more surprised to see how much green in Arizona, but and then more mountains in the distance beyond that. I see down here in this valley of Saguaro, this is on the south side of this bench or ledge that I'm standing on. It's a primitive BLM road anyways, and I don't know if it shows in the camera, but this valley floor here is not nearly so far down. It's just higher elevation than on this side. See, on this side it's a lot lower, so I had to climb higher. I had to climb more elevation coming from where I did. Whereas on this side, it'll be a shorter descent, and actually, looks like going right over there is going to be the way to do it. It's kind of gradual. That's not even near as steep as what I just came up. So it'll be longer distance-wise. So there's Saddle Mountain, and there's a canyon in between there and where I am. And I'm sure the video just is not doing justice to the depth of this. But you can see Now, if you see that little car out there, well, there's a tractor trailer on Interstate 10 going by. No, that's not Interstate 10. That's there's a tractor trailer out there on the road. That's golly, a mile or more away. You can see this SUV down here with a tent beside it. To give you an idea of the size of things. But anyway, this is the slope I just came up, and it was just, I mean, it's literally steeper than a staircase. So we're gonna try the backside for our way out of here. We'll see how that goes. Well, I made it down to about to the bottom here to where this road is that I saw from up top. So I'm gonna take this road around. I think it looks like it's gonna work around Saddle Mountain, and I should be able to get back to my camp from the front side of it. It'll be a longer distance, but it's it was an easier hike, and I only fell one more time coming down. I'll show you around here. This is where I came down from, just to the left of that high peak. That's where I was at. So I kind of worked my way down here, like so. And this is actually not nearly as steep as the other side. It's even further down to the valley floor over there. So this saved me, you know, I'll have to make that elevation change sooner or later, obviously, but it looks like I can do it on a road as opposed to in a wash that's crumbling under my feet. So let's go see what we can find our way back to camp. You know, people ask me routinely, why do you do this? What, you know, why put up with the aggravation and the hardships and inconveniences and whatever living out of a van? Well, it's, you know, days like today when I'm bruised and bloodied up from trying to fall off a mountain, but I'm standing up here in a gorgeous spot. Got it to myself, you know? That's why I do it. I mean, look at the view up here. You know, this is why I do it. It's to have opportunities like this. I think I'll talk more about that in another video, though. This one's long enough already, with all the adventures I've already had on this trip. And in case you're wondering, Deborah Dickinson made me send her my coordinates when she found out I was bleeding up here on the mountain. She wouldn't rest till I told her where I was at. So I do have people looking out for me. And my daughter and daughter-in-law are pretty vigilant about making sure I tell them where I'm camped and where I'm up to as well. So I didn't warn them about this little adventure today, so I'll probably hear about that. But time for me to start making my way down. I think I got a long hike to get back to the van. Yeah, I just was reading an article the other day, and they were talking about how they've done some new research, and being out in nature, going for a hike, positively improves people's attitude and mood and perspective on life. You know, it's not a surprise to any of us that spend any time in nature. We know that happens. I'm just walking along this dirt road here, having made it off that mountain. And, you know, there's just, I mean, it's beautiful, it's sunny, there's poppies blossoming all over the place here. Hope these all show up in the video. And I'm just thinking, you know, it is hard not to be in a good mood. Even bumped and scraped and bleeding a little bit from some tumbles on the mountain, it's hard not to love being out in nature like this. Here's a quick view of the south side of Saddle Mountain. I've been camped on the north side. Poppies are just growing like crazy all over the place here. There's a little shelf next to a wash. And as we come around into the wash, you see they're just all over as well. Really pretty, I mean, just so pretty. Okay, so I've been walking along that BLM dirt track, and I've gotten to the side of Saddle Mountain here. The other side of that little hill right there, between these, is where I need to get. That's my van's over on the other side of that. So I recognize the landmarks. So I'm gonna be off the road again and hiking up there. So I made it around the mountain. That's my van right in the middle there. So I still got a little ways to go to get to there. But I did find this nice little small cave right here in front of me. That's right at the base of Saddle Mountain. So that looks like a good spot to stop for a little rest break and a bite to eat. And then we'll go finish up the hike back to the van. Well, I made it back to the van after about a 4-hour adventure going up and over a mountain. Luckily, I went up and over through that pass there and around the back side of that and back through this pass on the back. So I made it back, only fell 5 times on loose rock on steep slopes. No serious injuries to report, so we'll call that all good, I guess. Well, I hope you enjoyed going along with me on that little hike. I didn't get quite as high up as I would have liked. I got some good elevation and some nice views, but I didn't get quite as high as I would have liked thanks to losing the trail. Of course, I don't even know how much of a trail that is. I haven't been able to really find solid information there. I know there is a trail, and it's supposed to take you up to one of the peak of one of the eastern, it's supposed to take you up to one of the eastern peaks, but I haven't been able to nail down exactly where it is or how to find it, so that may not have even been the right trail I was on. If it was, it just sort of disappeared in a wash and petered out, so I don't know. But it was fun. I enjoyed myself and hope you enjoyed the views I was able to share with you, and we'll see you in the next video.